You guys got to let everybody know this message that I'm about to give you, because this is something that I just found out. It's beyond belief. This is regarding a House resolution that was initiated on May 1st of this year. 6666. That is not an exaggeration. I have no idea how this works, but this is what the actual House resolution number is. 6666. And I'm going to read you what that House resolution is. Please make sure that you pass this on to every single person that you know. I don't care whether you're in the United States or not, you got to get this information out. House Rule 66, or House Resolution 6666, is for COVID-19 Testing, Reaching, and Contacting Everyone Act. The acronym is TRACE Act. Again, TRACE Act stands for Testing, Reaching, and Contacting Everyone. It was introduced by Bobby Rush, who is a Democrat from the state of Illinois. And they have introduced this bill into the House, and they are going to roll this out from a testing standpoint in Ventura County, California, which happens to be where I'm at right now. Basically, this act is to allow individuals to come into your house, and if you've got a cough, or somebody in your family has a cough, or they're gonna, or you have a fever, or anything that they determine that shows that you have COVID-19, regardless of whether you've been tested or not. They will also test people, but remember that testing already has been shown to be there to be a high rate of false positives. False positives meaning you don't have COVID-19, but the test shows it's false positive. It's showing up as positive, so they call it a false positive. We already know from the studies previously done, as far back as 1984, but as recently as 2018, that individuals that did not have COVID-19 or coronavirus, even in the cat model, cats that had never been exposed to coronavirus, tested positive if they had had a flu shot, if they had the trivalent or the covalent flu shot. And we don't know about the H1N1 shot, we don't know about the herpes zoster shot, the shingles shot. There's many other vaccines that people have gotten. We have no idea if people are going to be testing positive, have false positives based upon those tests. So the point is that the chance of them testing someone and them being positive is pretty doggone high, even if the person doesn't have COVID-19. But they're going to use that to pull you or your loved ones, especially your children, away under pretense of public safety. They're going to say that your child has to be removed from you because you have COVID-19, and so to protect your child, we're going to take that child, or we're going to take your grandmother or your father or you and put you into quarantine. This is a load of rubbish, because if you're in your home isolated, who are you going to expose? All right? And if they're going to try to take you away from your family, the chances of you having infected your family, even if you did really have COVID-19, is about 99.9%. So this is a bunch of BS. They're using this as an attempt to further divide us as individuals. They divided us from our friends, from our social circles. Now they're dividing us from our own family units. This is the most ominous sign so far that we've seen. I want you to all wake up. I want you to pass this information on. I want you to tell every single person that you know what's happening. If you're not in the United States, I don't care. It's coming to your country as well. And if you're in the United States, you need to contact your representatives. Right now, if you go to askdrbutard.com/ask, right underneath my image, you'll see that link. Go to that website, follow the information that it's asking, enter that information in, and then you're going to be taken to a page. The first one is a petition. It's a petition about censorship against media, that mainstream media has right now, as well as social platforms. Sign that petition. Second thing is a website, or is a link that'll take you to allow you to send any letter that you want to people on, to elected officials on the municipal level, on the state level.